Let me start by saying that just a little while ago, we received a call from FEMA. Hurricane Sandy, as it relates to Philadelphia, has now been deemed a Category 1 hurricane. There's been an enormous amount of communication and preparation to deal with this hurricane event, both here in Philadelphia, among our many public and private partners, and at the regional and national level as well.
If you are in the Barrier Islands still, I want to go back to this. You know, do not try to get out now unless you have information that there is a completely safe way to get out. The flooding is significant on the barriers, and you're putting yourself in danger. The best advice I can give you now, after you having ignored our advice all along, is to get to the highest point possible in the shelter you're in and to hunker down until 7 o'clock tomorrow morning, and then to call authorities to ask to be rescued. And we'll put you in queue behind the other people that we need to rescue, and we'll get those swift water boat folks out there to begin urban search and rescue throughout the areas of the Barrier Islands. I think we're staring at the worst 4 to 6 hours of the storm coming, starting in about 15 minutes or so, and then we'll be able to start to look to see, given how quickly the storm started to move now, and maybe by tomorrow early evening, the ability to start to look at damage assessment and see what we can do about beginning to assemble recovery teams. So that's where we are now. I'm happy that the storm has moved more quickly. I think it will help us, especially with flooding being less severe than it might have otherwise been, because it's coming more quickly and will miss, for the most part, the high tide period of this evening. So let's hope it doesn't slow down for some reason, hit shore, and then let's get moving and let's get everything done. So, you know, I'm still concerned the outages will go up significantly more. You're right. We've had some significant ones here, but not hurricane type ones, but we've had hurricane type ones at the coastline. And that's when you're seeing a lot of the outages happen. Also, the JCPL has made the decision to power down their substations on the Barrier Islands to avoid any further damage to the substation at the Barrier Islands. So, there's going to be little or no power in this Barrier Islands. May already have happened.